Hello, welcome back to Move, Nourish, Heal. It's Mike. We are here on the fifth day of the fifth week of this 40 Days to Personal Revolution series that we're like, we're plugging away. We're almost into the last week of it, and it is Yin Day, okay? So I am like, my body needs a nice restorative practice. I got my COVID vaccine yesterday, so I'm feeling my arm. No chaturangas today, okay? This is gonna be like more of a yin class. No vinyasa, just holding poses for longer periods of time. And the principles of yin, of giving it time, focusing on the breath, and really working at the edge, trying to get right to the edge of those poses and not rushing the process. Yin is the embodiment of don't rush the process, in my opinion, okay? So like really allowing your body to be still and to take time in those moments of compression in the joints and in the ligaments and the tendons, and really getting into a different form of healing than you can when you're moving through a powerful fiery vinyasa practice, which is what I also love deeply in my soul. But there's something about the balance between yin and yang. So we're going to move through 75 minutes. That's this week's time frame from the 40 Days to Personal Revolution program. If you're curious about that program, check it out. You could find that book online, written by Baron Baptiste, and I'm just participating right now. It's almost the last week. Next week, all the classes are going to be 90 minutes, and then I'll be probably focusing more on some food videos for a little while. Just, you know, the audio yoga video will still pop up. There's going to be more food stuff coming. So please hit the thumbs up. Please like this video. Please comment. And if you haven't subscribed, do that. Hitting the notification bell also lets you get a reminder or a notification whenever I'm going live or when I post new content. So all of that stuff helps the YouTube algorithm know that you're enjoying this channel and helps it get seen by more people. So I appreciate that, okay? We're gonna start somewhere different. We always start in child's pose, I feel like, and we're gonna start on our backs today in Supta Baddha Konasana, do a bunch of poses on our backs and just move through a really nice restorative yin practice today, okay? So taking the pose, come down onto your back. Mr. B's already in his yin there. He's in the Shavasana starting out. Lazy day. Hi, buddy. Just take your soles of your feet together and let your feet a little further away from your groin. Knees open wide. And then spread your right hand on your belly, your left hand on your heart. Allowing your breath to presence you here. And the breath doesn't have to be ujjayi breath. It doesn't have to be so fiery or so audible. But still really intentional. Still focused on the breathing. Doing it on purpose. Long breaths. Centering yourself right here in this first pose. If you actually have made it into this first pose, like I might have already scared away some of those power yoga yogis out there. And this is just really such a nice balance to the intensity and the movement that can come from a power practice. Centering yourself in stillness. Centering yourself in your breath, in the sensations of the physical body. Centering your thoughts by using those anchors, those tools to keep you here. Really being curious if it does agitate you to be still and hold poses longer, like maybe like me for the longest time, like what's the benefit? I'm not sweating, I'm not working muscles. There's a lot of evidence to show the benefits of yin. The compression of the joints, the longer holds in the stretches of the ligaments and the tendons actually increases mobility in a different way. Increases your range of movement, reduces pain, and actually stimulate synovial fluid, like the lubricating fluid in the joints. Collagen production, hyaluronic acid, lubrication of the skin. Just really a completely different experience than a power practice. And it's being true to yourself. Like if you start to have those moments of like, why am I doing this? I've been there. And just trusting that there is benefits that you get when you actually allow yourself to just sit still. Not rush. Benefits from a quick movement through a pose, benefits from vinyasa and increasing your heart rate and all of that amazing stuff. I'm not saying there isn't. But that doesn't mean there's no benefits to the opposite. Take about five more breaths in Supta. Breath can be much more gentle. Again, you're not going to hear my like fiery ujjayi breath rumbling through yin class. That's amazing pranayama. It's an amazing breathing practice to do. And if it fits for you, if that's what makes you like grounds you, it's okay. You can do whatever breathing fits for you. There's no like prescription. And just making the breaths really natural and intentional. Gentle. It's a different experience. Breathe in. Open your mouth and let it out. Now straighten out your legs. Just take your time. My intention was to do banana pose, and then I think I've got a dog in the way. Let me just see if I can make that work here still. I don't know how I'm going to talk about that. What do you think, B? You maybe want to like actually be on your bed for once? So with banana pose, and we'll start by stretching the left side of the body. So you're going to take your hands up over to the right side of your mat, on the opposite side of your dog's head. Take your feet over to the right side of your mat, and then just kind of shimmying the hips over to the left a little bit. It's kind of nice, yeah, the way that I was taught to do it, the way that I like it, actually. Oh, man. My water bottle just spilled. You just stay where you are. It's getting out of the way. We don't need that. So feet over to the right, arms over to the right, hips to the left. And then I like to take my left foot as far over as I can get it. And again, finding your edge, okay? So feel the stretch. Get your left foot over as far as you can, and then put the right foot on top of it. It's kind of like a way to anchor it down. Crossing the ankles with the right foot on top, hands up and over to the right, and then just allowing that stretch through the left side of your body. The way that I was taught yin is just doing the left side first. We do the right side first in yang in power yoga, and the left side first in yin. I know that's not the way every yin teacher teaches it. Doesn't really matter which side you do first in these poses, I suppose, but moving arms and legs to the right gives you that left side body stretch and really allowing just time to settle in. The moment you start to get antsy in the poses, the moment you start to feel agitated from just being still, if that even happens, it's just a point of awareness. Just commit to a different experience of yoga if you're used to power yoga. If you found this video because you love yin, then yeah, I'm not talking to you. Great, welcome. A lot of people that might be doing the 40 Days to Personal Revolution program, they're not yin yogis necessarily. People that practice yin regularly. If you're anything like me, for the first 7 years I did yoga, not somebody that likes to be still. Just over a year ago I did a training in yin and really started to appreciate just not just the physical experience and the relaxation that yin can bring, but the science and the benefits behind taking time. Letting the poses work their magic on you whenever you hold them way longer than you'd ever do in a vinyasa practice. think my appreciation for Ian has given me much deeper access to meditation. I'm on day 75 consecutive of meditating at least 15 minutes every day, and that's like a breakthrough for me. Sitting still has been a challenge. I get it, if that's you that I'm talking to. Just breathing through it. Just check if you can deepen that anymore. Feet over to the right a bit more, arms over to the right, and just stretching into that left side body. Your edge moves the longer you've been in a pose. Starting to feel this through the outer left hip, the left shoulder. I definitely feel that vaccine in my arm, like the kind of very tender. It's really moving right to that edge of your range of motion, edge of your comfort in the sensations. It's not necessarily comfortable, but it's definitely not painful. Not straining the body. Pushing it to its edge, though, as much you can. A few more breaths here. In and out. One more. Stay for that last little stretch. Not rushing in the transitions of yin. Take the time, come out of the pose very slowly. Just kind of starfish for a moment. Arms and legs open up. Just allowing yourself to feel the sensations and like slowly the dissipation of that energy that pools in the different areas where there's compression in a yin pose. If you like a little bit of movement, you can take it. I kind of prefer to just be in stillness and let the sensations be experienced, but it's, again, it's your practice. Do what you need to do. Just avoiding the fidgeting. It's being still when you're in the holds. We'll move on to the other side, banana. So just take your arms up and over your dog. So the arms up over to the left side. Take your right foot as far to the left as you can get it, right at that edge, and then hook your left foot up and over the right to anchor it down. Making your body into a banana shape. Keep that right shoulder on the mat as best you can. If you want to take it, you can like take hold gently with the left hand around the right wrist and kind of just gently pull up and over more. Getting to where you feel a stretch happening in that right side body. And land where you land and start to breathe. The benefit of yin comes from the stillness. So yeah, as we sit in the pose after, you know, 90 seconds or so, you can check in with it, the edge moved, and kind of deepen it a little bit, but it's not every breath checking. Not fidgeting, not coming out and coming back in over and over again. Like, if those things happen, just acknowledge yourself, have some compassion, but be true to yourself. And if you're doing a yin practice, one of the principles of yin is the stillness. That's part of the meditative component of it, is really resisting the urge to wiggle, fiddle, scratch the edge, whatever it is. Just breathing through it.
breathing deep, generous breaths. Check in if there's space to take it a little deeper. Just moving the hands and the feet a few centimeters, millimeters may be enough to get you into more of a stretch through that right side body, shoulder, hip. Breathing. Just allowing stillness and time. The work. Where are your thoughts? It's the work of centering yourself back to this moment over and over again, not rushing the process. If you catch yourself thinking about what comes after this practice, come back. Analyzing it, come back to experiencing it. About five more breaths. Breathe in. Stay for the breath out. Again, really slowly allow yourself to come out of it. Don't rush out of that. Starfish, arms and legs spread to the corners of the mat. Feel the sensations in the body. One more pose on our back. Let's incorporate one of the poses from this week in the Journey into Power sequence in the book. So we'll hold fish for longer than five breaths today. Okay, so coming up onto the forearms and then tucking your fingers underneath the tops of your bum cheeks here. Let your head fall back. Keep the shoulders so pulling the shoulder blades back, but with yin, it's not as important to worry about all the integration and alignment. It's really just finding a place where your body can land. Throat open, heart open. You might get back to where your head hits the ground. This might work for you. Maybe it's too deep. Hold here for a couple minutes, just breathing. This is a big opener through the throat and the heart. So just allow any sensations, any emotions, any thoughts just to come and go. fish pose. I like my heels together with my toes opening out. I feel like it's like a fishtail. I don't know if that's proper form, but again, the alignment for your body, it's really how your body lands. Power yoga and vinyasa yoga, there's a focus on alignment because you're moving quickly and you don't want to be out of alignment and cause repetitive movements that might lead to injury. Yin is different. Yin's really not like no alignment. It's just general shapes of the poses. However your body can land in them. Some compression, a little discomfort. Just sitting in it, not moving through it quickly. No high impact. Five more breaths. Breathe in. Though. One more. Slowly let your shoulders come back down to the mat for a second. Take your hands out from underneath your glutes. Take a quick shavasana, just lay here for a moment. It much more relaxing. And we're gonna gently come up to sit. Just take your time, roll up, just sit. And we'll take caterpillar pose, so seated forward bent. Okay, so feet out in front of you, get the sit bones out behind you, draw the bum cheeks back a bit. Instead of grabbing your feet and pulling into it like we would do in a power class, it's just taking the forearms to the ground on either side of your legs. And allowing the upper body to round forward. If you need a prop, if it's too much for your neck, you can put a block or like a bolster or something on your legs to rest your forehead on. Just allowing the neck to round, the chin to tuck in towards your chest. And breathe. Find your edge into a nice deep fold. Let go of muscles that you might be holding on to. As little muscle engagement as possible in a hold for yin, really just getting into the stretching, the lengthening of the tendons and the ligaments. Feel space, feel that stretch between the vertebrates of the neck and the thoracic spine. Yourself to be still. Putting importance on stillness. How often do you actually do that? Some of you watching this, it might be all the time.
all you ever do is sit in meditation and in yin, then I would challenge you to do some more yang sometimes, more fire, more challenging intensity. Not all the time, but like add it in, balance it out. If you are someone that's a fireball, that's always going and doing, amazing. I challenge you to do more of nothing. It's like doing nothing is doing something. Creating space. Giving yourself time to actually just land, get centered. Check your edge, see if you can go any deeper. Do about 10 more breaths. Generous breaths, not shallow. Full breaths. Hold any muscles. A few more. Slowly back up to sit. We're going to move into deer pose from here. Okay, so for deer, you're going to take your shin parallel to the top of your mat, and then take your right heel on top of your left knee with your left shin parallel to the left side of your mat. Okay, and from here, there's options here. We can twist it a little bit so you can come down. Like with a twist away from to the right side of your body, or you can come down in front. Whatever feels good to you. I'll give you both options. I like it in front. Just coming down onto your forearms, rounding the head forward. If you've twisted to one side, you can use a block or a bolster under your arms if you need it to have somewhere to support yourself. Go with the head, settle into the hips, I should really say at the beginning of these yin classes, like I don't put music just because music is so subjective. Really your choice. If you want to put music on in the background of these classes, that's obviously your prerogative to do that, right? What I find relaxing might not be what you find relaxing or restorative. So it's just like I talk a little less in the yin classes, like a lot less sometimes. So there's no cueing per se, it's just reminders to be in stillness and breathe. Music is something that you will deepen your practice for you, then amazing. If it's a distraction, you can leave it out. if you can go any further, maybe walk the arms out a little bit further in front of you. Maybe some compression in that right hip. Whichever variation you chose to be in right here, stay in it, yeah? Looking at your edge, sometimes you might go too far. If you've gotten somewhere that's like unbearable, excruciating, that's not the practice. It's not to stay through pain. Sometimes you can back off a little bit if you need to. But if it's just discomfort, if you can stay, then stay. Breathe through. Create space. Just being still. Just being with whatever might come up for you right here in this moment without needing to run from it, without needing to distract yourself from it. Breathing through it. Go 5 more breaths. Breathe in. Breathe out. Slowly, slowly come back up. We'll take Baddha Konasana, butterfly. Soles of the feet together, knees wide. Just take your time with the transitions, don't rush. Feet, it's really your choice of placement. Again, there's no specific alignment, but if a feet like a little further away or a little closer to the groin, wherever it lands for you, just take the hands out in front of you and let the upper body round forward. Tuck the chin, round the neck. Just find your edge right here. Muscles that are working too much. Sometimes sometimes a muscle might be active. A lot of these poses, once the form is set up, some of them, yeah, you're holding up muscles to keep limbs in certain places, but like once you're here in this pose and everything's in the shape of the pose, it's just letting go of the muscles and letting your body settle into it, settle into that shape. Opening space. Check if you can go any deeper, if your edge is moved. Couple more breaths. Inhale and exhale. Slowly come back up. We'll move into deer pose on the other side. Okay, so turning left shin parallel to the top of the mat, right shin parallel to the right side of the mat. Again, twisting over to the left side or coming down over the front leg here. See, I even forgot to do the left side first, but that's okay. Whatever side you've done, do the other side. Edge will be different from side to side sometimes. Just allow yourself to settle in, find that spot. Your body, being present to this moment, centered in it, breath by breath.
your edge. See if you can go a little deeper. Settle in. Breathe. Challenge in yin. I know for me the challenge is to just stay present without any distractions, and I'm intentionally not talking as much as, you know, anyone that does classes with me on this channel knows I can talk through the whole thing. Just really allowing there to be some space for you to do the work of being in stillness. And it doesn't just mean holding the poses without fidgeting. The stillness is in the mind. Just like any other skill, the muscle, like the more you work that stillness muscle, that skill of just keeping the thoughts centered, centering breath by breath back to the present moment, becomes easier each time you do it, like second nature. Five more breaths. Deep breaths. Stay for the breath out. Slowly come back up. Take your time. No rushing out of the yin poses, okay? Sitting up tall. We're gonna move into a straddle fold. Just gonna turn sideways so I have room. Keeping the legs wide. Legs as wide as they can be for you, comfortably. Can be arms out in front of you with the arms straight. This is enough. Just allowing yourself to start to lean forward into it. If you have the mobility, come onto forearms. Feels like the right thing to do, you can come maybe all the way down to your hands stacked and the forehead on the hands. Starting to feel that inner thigh, the groin muscles, not pulling, you're not forcing any strain where there might be an injury, but you're getting to that edge. It'll be a little uncomfortable probably. Find your edge in the pose. Muscles. Breathe into it and just start to melt deeper, right? Your body feels the sensations. Feel the pose working on your body. You're in the right shape. Five more breaths. Breath in, out, very slowly, slow, come back up.
You can just take your legs out in front of you, arms out behind you for a moment, just rest there. Oh, don't rush. Feel that in your legs. Let the head fall back. Bring your legs into comfortable cross-leg seated position, whatever that feels like for you. Take a side body and a neck stretch here. So working the left side of the body first, you'll just come down onto your right forearm with the left arm up and over the head. And it's just kind of a lean in. If you need a block, this can be a good place for a prop if you need it, okay, to bring the arm up a bit higher. I'll actually use one here today because I'm feeling my left arm from that shot that I got yesterday. And you can just rest your arm on top of your head, kind of deepening that stretch through the neck. Just letting go, no holding muscles in that left arm, just letting it rest on the side of the head. Big side body stretch, feel it through the neck, feel it through the arm and shoulder. Crunched up in the right shoulder and your neck, you can put a little bit of pressing down through the right elbow, or it can be the arm further out to the side. This works as well. Just really feeling it through the left side body, whatever you need to do. Get your body in the shape. Do about five more breaths here. The left side body up.
One more breath in and out. Slowly come back up. Take your time. Don't rush out of the poses. And then we'll move into the other side. Okay, so taking, again, different options. It can be all the way down to the forearm if you have the mobility, forearm to a block. Taking the right arm up and over and just resting on the side of the head. Start where you start, get into the shape of the pose, and after a little bit, we'll check in with the edge if it's moved. If there's somewhere that'll bring more sensations, we can go there then. Through the right side body. Just check if you want to go anywhere further into it. Leaning over to the left, just letting the weight of the arm rest on the side of the head, opening the side of the neck, the side body. More in out. Breathe here. Just hold for the exhale. Slowly come back up to sit. And we'll take double pigeon on the left side with the left leg on top. Just take your time to set it up. Ankles and knees are stacked, okay? So you're not sitting just cross-legged like we just were for the last pose. There's a stacking of the joints. It's called square pose, actually, in yin. I think, comment below if I got the name wrong, but yeah, I'm pretty sure this is called square. And then you're gonna just lean forward over the legs. This can be sitting up tall if that's what you need. All the poses that I can think of, this is probably the one where my edge moves the most in a hold. If you want to hold up your head, you can. I just really like to round it and feel that stretch through the neck and the thoracic. Feet are kind of flexed. You don't need to put a lot of work in the leg muscles, but just keeping the feet flexed a little bit will keep you in the stretch. Again, not too much engagement. Find your edge. Just breathe into it. for your edge. Go deeper if there's room. That's what fits. Do about 10 more breaths here. Will start to build. Feel that pooling of energy in the joints. Breathe into it. Exhale. One more breathe in. Empty. Slowly, slowly come back up. Unravel your legs. Straight out in front of you. Oh, don't rush. Especially in the end when you're holding longer. Just let that take your time. Sitting up tall, take like a staff pose for a moment. Just let the legs be out in front of you, palms on either side of your body. If you want them a little further back, you can lean back into it. That's okay too. Feel your legs, just acknowledge that. Just that energy dissipating slowly. Breath in and another breath out. We'll set up the other side with the left leg on top, or sorry, right leg on top. Square pose, double pigeon. Get your sit bones back out of the way. Ankles and knees stacked. Squaring that off. Passion for the two sides of your body being different. Find where your edge starts you out. Still feeling, breathing. Your edge, check in if there's anywhere that you can take it. Go there, land.
about 10 more breaths. Settle in. Keep breathing. Don't hold your breath. Don't clip it short. Natural breaths. In. Out. Take one more. Hold for the exhale. Slowly come back up. Unravel the legs. Take your time, please. Take your knees bent with your feet as wide as your mat. Arms up behind you for support there and let your knees rest at center. Just hold here, shoulders back, head back. Feel that energy moving from your hips. Full breath in. Out. Just a couple more like that. Really generous breath, just holding here, letting that energy dissipate from the hips, the knees. Come back up. Gonna move into frog pose. Not an outrageously long hold, but we're gonna hold it. Okay, moving into frog, taking the knees wide. Knees in line with hips, okay? The tendency will be to take a lot of the sensations out as if you come away in front of the hips with the, sorry, in front of the knees with the hips. Keep them in line. Come down onto your forearms. Just check your edge. As wide as they'll go, maybe down onto your chest, forehead on your stacked hands. If you need to roll up the mat for padding under your knees or anything like that, like make yourself so that you can be, you know, comfortable in the discomfort, if that makes sense. Some compression on your joints is good, but not if it's like all you can think about and it takes you out of the mental practice of being centered here. Settle in. Almost near the end of this practice. Just one last hip opener. Get right to the juicy spot. With those sensations acting on your body,
your mind here. Aware of the sensations, but not fixated on them, not distracted by them, not suffering through them. We've got another minute here, 10 breaths or so. Take a deep breath in, take a deep breath out, one more to sink into those hips for this last exhale.
Really slowly bring yourself up out of that, knees together, don't rush. Come onto your back. Let's take your time. Draw both of your knees up into your chest. Sorry, not sorry for the dog snoring. It's pretty relaxing. He's like literally in my ear. You're pretty chilly, Mr. B. Take your knees over to the right side, supine twist. Where your feet are depends on what you want it, like where you want the stretch to be. So you can have your heels a bit closer to your bum, further away, like the amount of bend in the knees. It's totally up to you. Just find a place that feels good. Shoulders resting on the mat. Gaze over the left shoulder. Oh, you're making me tired, Mr. B. Just breathe. I don't know if you guys can hear the Rottweiler gas during these classes, but he's an extremely gassy Rottweiler lately. So, just to be clear, if it was me, I'd own it. It's him. Just seemed to slide out. Let go of any muscles, yeah? Just allow that twist to happen. Sinking into it. Breathe in. Breathe out. Take a couple more. Knees back to center. Shift your hips over to the right a little bit. Drop your knees over to the left. It's dog today. About 10 more breaths here. Snoring right in my ear. I just want to have a nap now. Oh my god. I feel the dog. Breathe in. Breathe out. Take one more here. Really feel that twist. Shoulders grounded down. Full breath in. Exhale. Take the knees up to the ceiling. Center your hips. Level off your shoulders. Make sure everything feels like it's in the right place. Knees into your chest. Just make a couple circles in each direction if you want to do that. And then release to Shavasana. Rest here. Feel your body, experience all of those sensations that you've just kind of developed, created in the last 75 minutes. Hear the sound of Bowser snoring in my ear. Try not to fall asleep. Be present to deep rest. Physically, mentally centered, this moment, grounded here. And ease.
breaths.
Deepen the breath. Each exhale is releasing any last little drop of tension left in the body. Breathe in. Breathe out. Take a deep inhale here. Open your mouth, let it go. Arms up over your head, a big stretch. Roll onto one side with your eyes still closed. Slowly, slowly, friend, bring yourself up to a seated position. Sitting up tall. Hands at your heart center. Take a deep breath in. Let it go. Thumbs to your forehead center. The stillness in me acknowledges the stillness in you. We'll finish this practice together with a bow.
Thank you.
All right, 75 minutes of yin, probably a little over. I feel like just a bit over 75, but comment and let me know how that felt. If you made it all the way through to the end here, please hit the thumbs up and let me know that you're enjoying this content, okay? We're almost done this last week. Tomorrow is gonna be a 75-minute live stream, Journey into Power class, okay? So come back for that. Hopefully my arm is gonna be back, ready to go for some chaturangas. I think I actually could probably do it, so. Yeah, I'm just commenting below the video and let me know how it felt in your body. Let me know if you're still in this practice, still in the 40 Days to Personal Revolution program. If you're doing this later in the future and you found these videos, please let me know that you found them as a resource and if they're helping you. And keep moving your body, keep nourishing your body, stay connected to a movement practice as often as you can. And I will see you again really soon. Yin dog.